In a research study, there is usually an experimental group and a comparison or control group. Those who are in the experimental group will get whatever's being researched in the study. Those in a control group will usually get the standard treatment for the condition. If there is no standard treatment, those in the control group might get a placebo that looks the same but is not intended to have the same effect as the experimental treatment, or they might get nothing at all. A control group is needed because people will naturally change a bit from one day to the next, even without being in a study. Some days people feel good and some days they feel a bit worse. Sometimes just knowing they are in a study can change the way a person feels. Even some blood tests can be different from one time to the next because of things like diet, stress, hormones, or mood. And sometimes things can change without any known reason. Since everyone in a study will experience different natural changes, researchers can measure the changes in each person, add them together, and find the average change for each group. If the average change in all the groups is the same, then the changes in any one person, whether for better or worse, are probably due to natural variation and not whatever is being researched. However, if the average change in the experimental group is much better or worse than in the control group, it's likely that the new treatment is what's making a difference. A control group is used to help researchers know the difference between these natural changes and the true effects of whatever is being researched.